At the beginning of the movie, we see a couple, and the wife's name is Jaelyn. They'd arrived at a beach on the seashore. They are actually here to spend their vacation. And the house where they stayed on the seashore was virtually above the water and made entirely of wood. Jaelyn's child died some time ago, which has caused her a great deal of tension. But because her husband loves her, he takes excellent care of her. They both go out and enjoy the day together on the island and also do adventure sports on the sea beach. They travel throughout the day seeing different tourist sites. After that, they go to a beachside cafe, where Jaelyn calls her mom. They become too involved in their conversation, when it was announced in the news that a massive storm was approaching the sea. However, they are unaware of this. Following that, these two enter the water to dive. During this time, Jaelyn's husband's leg is injured, causing blood to flow. She is now nervous after seeing the blood, because she was reminded of her history when her child died before he was born. But, once again, her husband looks after her and heads her home. Then while they are in the wooden house, dark clouds could be seen in the background. Jaelyn tells her husband that they can't stay here as she does not have that good feeling anymore, although unaware of the cyclone warning. Her husband understands that and tells her that they would leave the next morning. Sometimes later they both fall asleep and by that time the conditions have already deteriorated, as the cyclonic storm is underway and huge waves began to crash on the wooden platform. Jaelyn is awakened by a loud noise, but they do not pay much attention. Then they receive a phone call asking them if they want to relocate. But Jaelyn says they are okay as they think that it's an ordinary storm situation and it would pass soon. Then they go back to sleep once again. Then, while they were sleeping, the big waves of the sea began to collide with their house. Their entire house, which was made entirely of wood, is destroyed by the tremendous waves of the sea. Waters begin to enter, and their house begins to submerge in the flood. Because of the circumstances, they were both concerned. Outside, they notice some rocks on the seashore, and Jaelyn instructs her husband to go there. Her husband, however, refuses her, stating that there is a very violent storm outside and that they should stay inside since they could drown and die. They sleep there after that. When Jaelyn wakes up in the morning, she notices that there is water all around her. And they're both stranded in the middle of the sea with their broken house. When Jaelyn notices this, she becomes enraged at her husband, because she also told her husband last night that they should go to the seaside rocks. Her husband, however, refused. And because they are in the middle of the sea, far from the shore, no one can see them or come to their aid, so they needed to find a way out of there. Her husband, however, was unable to swim due to a serious wound on his leg. They were also starving and thirsty. However, because everything had been drowned, they now had nothing to eat nor water to drink. Then her husband asks her to go down and see for herself. There must be food and drinking water available. Even though Jaelyn is terrified of water, she goes in nevertheless. From there, she brings a bag containing water with her. She offers that water to her husband to drink in order to cure his health problem. Her husband now tells her not to worry, and he assures someone will come here to find them. They lay down there after that. They now hear the sound of the helicopter, and Jaelyn comes to discover that the helicopter is indeed flying in the sky. And they tilt the bottle's water towards the sun, and try to make smoke out of the sun's rays, so that when they see the smoke, someone comes to their aid. However, their strategy did not work. They were now in the midst of a major dilemma, but they remained courageous and cheerful. Unfortunately, it was a long distance away. That is why the helicopter fails to see them. So they leave right in front of Jaelyn's eyes. Despite the fact that she was screaming and yelling, she is waving her hand to summon them, but they are unable to see her. After a while, she notices a ship a few miles away from them. She waves her hand again to summon them. However, due to the distance, the ship does not see them. Meanwhile, her husband opens his eyes and attempts to make smoke from the bottle once more. He was successful this time since the smoke had begun to fly. The ship had turned before the people on board could notice the smoke. It had moved far away from them, making both of them terribly sad once again. Furthermore, their problems were worsening because the fire they had started to burn the smoke had now spread throughout their wooden house. That is why everything begins to burn. The fire was spreading, so they had to plunge into the water beneath the wooden house. After plunging into the water, they noticed that their entire wooden house is on fire, where they had taken shelter a while ago to save their lives. They were swimming in the water with the help of several pieces of wood in front of them. Because her husband had a deep wound on his leg, causing his blood to flow, and because of the blood smell, the sharks started coming there. When he sees them, he says they'll have to sit on a large piece of wood soon. Looking around, they notice a massive piece of wood a few distances away. And now, they swiftly climb on that piece of wood before the sharks approach and make them their prey. But they notice that these are not sharks, but dolphins. That's why they began laughing, as they mistook them for sharks. They both now lie down on that piece of wood, waiting for aid. Jaelyn claims that everything happened because of her, because if her child had not died, she would not have been stressed, and they would not have come here for the holidays. Her husband responds that she is not at blame in this situation and that they will absolutely make it out alive. And they will live happily ever after. Now while talking, they fall asleep. Blood is rapidly oozing from her husband's leg, which has spread throughout the water, and when Jaelyn opens her eyes, she is horrified to realize that her piece of wood moved far from her husband's piece of wood. Now the real sharks had arrived. Her husband's health was failing, so she needed to get to him. That is why she leaps and, with the assistance of a small piece of wood, begins to make her way to him. After smelling the blood, the sharks attack them. As a result, her husband likewise falls off his piece of wood. But Jaelyn manages to climb the piece of wood and pull her husband up with her. But by then, the shark had already attacked him several times. When Jaelyn notices this, she constructs an oar and removes the large piece of wood, which she is riding and her husband is clinging to for support. And she's sleeping there because she's exhausted. Her husband, too, unknowingly stands on that piece of wood. When Jaelyn opens her eyes, she realizes they are on the beach. She was overjoyed, so she worked hard to wake up her husband. Despite her best efforts, he does not wake up. As a result, she realizes her husband is no longer alive. She was terrified and broken by this situation. That's why she begins crying while hugging him. She became so concerned that she began shouting aloud. As a result, she collapses and goes unconscious. When she awakens in the morning, she notices that her husband's body is not on the shore. Because the big waves of the sea drag him back into the water, where there is death, that is, there are big, big, bloody sharks. Jaelyn now sees her husband's lifeless body in the ocean, being pulled by the sharks, and there is nothing that she can do except for watching her husband's lifeless body being eaten by the sharks. She walks towards the shore as the water level kept increasing and hits her bare legs several times with the corals underneath the water. Following the blood coming out from her legs, the sharks began to chase her as she runs towards the shore. Meanwhile, a shark attacks her and severely injures her leg. Jaelyn fights the shark by kicking it with her other leg as the shark continues to attack her. Then she grabs a coral from below the water and hits it repeatedly. The shark flees after getting injured. Jaelyn returns to the coast and dresses her wound by tearing a piece off her cloth. She walks a little distance and falls to the ground, unconscious. When she wakes up, she notices the dust flying toward her. Then after walking some good distance with her injured leg, she notices a rock. She rapidly, although not without difficulty, climbs on it. She then notices a man lying in a round boat on the water. He came here to catch fish because he is a fisherman. Jaelyn was overjoyed to see him. Because he appeared to Jaelyn to be a ray of hope, she rushes into his boat and wakes him up first. Then she attempts to explain that her husband died in the water because he was severely injured and she is now stranded on this island. She seeks help, but the man is uneducated. That explains why he doesn't understand English. Jaelyn conveys to him, with difficulty, that she requires help. In addition, she displays her wounded leg, which the man treats with medicine and bandages. He has come here to catch fish because he is a fisherman. That is why he leaps into the sea to lay his trap and begins to descend into the depths of the sea. He was still putting up the trap after he came down. That's when the shark attacks him. This creates a commotion in the water. Jaelyn realizes the shark has attacked him. That is why she screams and calls out to him. However, there is no response from the front. He eventually comes up to the water. However, he is injured. At the same moment, there was blood in the water, because the shark attacked him and severely injured him. Jaelyn jumps into the ocean to save his life, so she may get that fisherman onto the boat because he is injured, but the shark has returned. When Jaelyn notices this, she rushes into the boat. But before she could even bring that man in the boat, the shark attacks him and kills him. It drags him into the ocean and eats him. Jaelyn was now considering what she should do. That's when the shark comes after her again. Jaelyn gets a sharp blade in this boat, which is spinnable. She grabs it and attacks the shark. As a result, the shark is forced to flee the area. But the shark was not about to abandon her so easily. That's why it's starting to follow her boat again. It performs a high jump after getting close. The boat is turned upside down into the water. Jaelyn was now under the boat. She is terrified because she knows the shark will come after her again and will attack her as well. Perhaps it will kill her. Then she has an idea that will save her life. With her legs, she ties the rope to the sharp blade. Now the shark had no idea. That is where is she going now? And where is that blade going? And when it rises from below to attack Jaelyn, the blade enters its mouth and passes through. As a result, this vicious shark has been killed. Blood is poured into the water as soon as it dies. Jaelyn discovers that the shark has died. She then pulls the rope from the boat with all her power and eventually breaks it free. As a result of the rope, the shark's body begins to sink into the water. She then lies in the same boat, staring up at the sky. Then her boat arrives at a location while floating. From where the shore was visible, there were some fishermen among those present. Those fishermen also noticed Jaelyn's boat and realized that there is someone on this boat who requires assistance. When she sees them, a wave of happiness rises within her. Jaelyn now takes a deep sigh of relief as she stares up at the sky. Despite the fact that she is devastated by the loss of her husband, she had not given up her courage. She now has a new life that she wants to live. With this scene, the movie ends.